Byron Martin here at Logie's Greenhouses, and today we're going to be talking about the Mimosa pudica, or the sensitive plant. This is actually quite a popular plant in the world of horticulture, mainly because it has this interesting mechanism that allows the plant to move, so it's a plant that actually does something rather than being somewhat static. So what happens is that when something jiggles or touches the leaf, the leaves collapse. And this is a plant that kids really love because they can watch the plant actually doing something. Mimosa pudica, or the sensitive plant, is actually a weed in its native habitat, which is South America. It grows along roadsides, grows in poor areas. It's a legume, so it actually fixates nitrogen, which gives it its nutrients. As a potted plant, it is somewhat difficult to grow, and many people have difficulty with it, mostly related to the watering issues. So it's a plant that grows out in full sun, bright sun, long sides of roads and open areas. That's the key, give it as much light as possible. And it's a plant that goes through quite a bit of dryness. Now, in containers, you can dry it out too much and kill it. But probably the greatest cause of stress on it is too much water. And we see a lot of root rot in it when it's kept like evenly moist. So, particularly in growing this, you want to make sure that the soil becomes visually dry. It's our general rule of thumb in terms of watering anyway. And then let it go a little bit farther. You want to keep your eye on the plant as you start to learn how to grow this so that you see a little bit of wilt in it, and then water it. So you want to bring it a little bit beyond what you normally would think of in terms of dryness when you're watering it. And that's key to keeping that root system healthy, which if you do that, the plant will actually thrive in a sunny window. One other issue that they do face, and you have to be aware of this, is that they are susceptible to spider mite. And spider mite starts out as a small pitting on the leaf. You'll look at the leaves very closely, you can see pitting on them, little flecks. If you turn the leaf over and look at it with a magnifier, you'll find a small mite crawling on the backside that's feeding on the leaf. This can easily be remedied by a cold water wash, which would be simply pick the plant up, go over to your sink and take your spritzer and just wash that backside and the top of the leaf off. Usually I hold my fingers over it so the soil doesn't drop into the sink, then set it back down. And if you can remember to do that every day for a week, that pretty much cleans out a spider mite problem. One of the interesting parts of growing this is that it does flower. So here we have a plant that's going into bloom. It has these pretty little pink flowers that come on top. It's in the mimosa family, which gives you that round flower. It also is a very free producer of seed. And generally when we look at growing mimosa, we think of it as more of a short-term plant. It's not something that we really keep around for years. Almost like an annual, although we can keep them in containers for a number of years. With pruning and so on, but you can think of it almost as an annual, and it freely produces seeds, so you can harvest the seed and plant it, and it's very easy to germinate. Generally, if you have a seed like that, you might put four or five in a pot, and that quickly fills out, very rapid grower, by the way, so it quickly fills the pot out. So you can see they're quite stalky in their growth, and so they do benefit from pruning, and in doing that, generally we don't want to prune them too hard. I would probably take a plant like, this has two seedlings in it, so I'd take a plant like that and maybe cut it here or maybe down a little bit lower. And so what we've done, we've taken the top off. That's going to force some of these side branches to fill out. And as it's a fast grower, it comes out, flowers, cut it back, bring it back down, bring it back down. And you can do that over a period of time. Thank you for watching today. There's a little bit of information on how to grow Mimosa pudica, or the sensitive plant. If you'd like more information, you can visit us at logies.com.